In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty God, our Father, who spoke to the prophet Zechariah of the dawn from on high that breaks upon us, as an illuminating light shining forth in the darkness of the world, bring our clamorous souls to the silence we so desperately need in order to receive this light in a new and fresh way during this Advent season. In assuming the lowliness of human flesh, you fulfill the design you formed long ago and open for us the way to eternal salvation. For all the oracles of the prophets foretold him, the Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when he came. May our souls wait in silence for the coming of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, a silence that hears the praise of the angels for your great work of salvation, a silence that hungers for your presence, a silence that receives your holy word in the depths of our souls. As we do so, may you find us watchful in prayer and exultant in praise, awaiting his coming in glory. We make this prayer through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Our Lady of Divine Providence,
pray for us.
Saint Benedict and Saint Scholastic,
pray for us.
While gentle silence enveloped all things, and night in its swift course was now half gone, your all-powerful word, O Lord, leapt from heaven, from the royal throne. Be silent, all people, before the Lord, for he has roused himself from his holy dwelling.
Thank you.
Therefore, I will hope in you. The Lord is good to those who wait for him, to the soul that seeks him. It is good that one should wait quietly for the salvation of the Lord.
There was a great wind, so strong that it was splitting mountains and breaking rocks in pieces before the Lord. But the Lord was not in the wind. And after the wind, an earthquake. But the Lord was not in the earthquake. And after the earthquake, a fire. But the Lord was not in the fire. And after the fire, a sound of sheer silence. For God alone, my soul waits in silence, for my hope is from him. I wait for the Lord, my soul waits, and in his word I hope.
Thank you. Thank you.
She was greatly troubled at the saying, and considered in her mind what sort of greeting this might be. And the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus. The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore,
is the bridegroom. Come out to meet him. The voice of my beloved. Look, he comes, leaping upon the mountains, bounding over the hills. It is I, Jesus, who sent my angel to you with this testimony from the churches. I am the root and the descendant of David, the bright morning star. The Spirit and the bride say, come. And let everyone who hears say, come. And let everyone who is thirsty come. Let anyone who wishes take the water of life as a gift. Surely I am coming soon. Amen. Come, Lord Jesus.
Time came for her to be delivered.
and she gave birth to her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn.
Joy to the world, the Savior brings, that heaven.
the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were filled with fear. And the angel said to them, "Be not afraid, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy, which will come to all the people. For to you is born this day, in the city of David, a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among men with whom he is pleased." The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him. Yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born of the blood, or of the will of the flesh, or of the will of man, but of God. and the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his glory, the glory as of the Father's only Son, full of grace.
Thank you.
and worship him. When they had heard the king, they went on their way, and lo, the star which they had seen in the east went before them, till it came to rest over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced exceedingly with great joy. And going into the house, they saw the child with Mary his mother, and they fell down and worshipped him. Then, opening their treasures, they offered him gifts, gold and frankincense and myrrh. And being warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they departed to their own country by another way. But Mary kept all these things, pondering them in her heart.
It is good. though he calls grief, he will have compassion according to the abundance of his steadfast love. For he does not willingly afflict or grieve the sons of men. And God himself will be with them. He will wipe every tear from their eyes. Death will be no more. Mourning and crying and pain will be no more.
God abides in him.
was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulder, and his name will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
Thank you. grant us the grace to cast away the works of darkness, O Lord, we pray, so as to put on the armor of light. Show us the path to enter into the silent stillness of your presence. We might learn to listen with the ear and our heart. To enter the silent stillness of your presence, may it be so now in the time of this mortal life, in which your Son, Jesus Christ, came in great humility, that in the last day, when he comes again in his glorious majesty, he might rise to live immortal. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. May the Almighty and Merciful God, by whose grace you have placed your faith in the first coming of his only begotten Son, and yearn for his coming again, sanctify you by the radiance of Christ's advent, and enrich you with his blessing.
Amen.
As you run the race of this present life, may you make you firm in faith, joyful in hope, and active in charity. So that rejoicing now with devotion at the Redeemer's coming in the flesh, you may be endowed with the rich reward of eternal life when he comes again in majesty.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you in name.
Thank you.
Thank you.